Good evening, sports fans. My name is Magnitude, and welcome to the GBA Global Battle Associate Finals. Association Finals. I'm here, joined by my color commentator.
Hello, everybody.
You can introduce yourself?
I'm Kyle, owner of the Chicago Grambles.
Yeah, we're the two worst teams in the league. We have our third color commentator. You got lost in the way here, but we have the Arizona D-Oxys, number one overall seed, going up against the Los Angeles Nidokings. We're taking the side of the Arizona D-Oxys strictly because that was number one overall seed. We have a team here. We have Gengar. Or sorry, this is the opposite side. I apologize. The Nidokings. The LA Nidokings. Because this is the LA Nidokings team. We're on the side of the Arizona D-Oxys.
It is.
Holy crap. All right. So this is the... Wow. Already having the problems. We are actually here 13 feet away from the charred remains of the Chernobyl explosion.
Oh, okay.
Chernobyl
yes.
disaster.
Yeah.
So we have primo location.
Yeah.
But we have.
I can feel my skin tingling now.
Fantastic. Well, thanks for joining us, Nick. Here at the you finally found your way here to the.
It's a pleasure to be here. The traffic coming into and out of Chernobyl is just it's unbearable.
No bueno. But we have this is look at the team here of the Arizona or of the Los Angeles Nidokings. I can't speak, which is awful because I'm the lead guy. But no, this is happening live right in front of us, right in front of our faces. We have no idea what's going to happen.
It's true. We honestly
have no idea the team of the D-Oxys, what they're going to bring at all. So we're going to play it by ear and we'll see what happens.
Let's get it into it.
Because we do know the team. I can tell you the team right now if you'd like.
Is that necessary?
Nope, it's not necessary at all. let's do it. This is set to be a good video, a good, nice, long one. I know, make the jokes. So we have a lead of Nidoking and a lead of Star Raptor. Now, the D-Oxys with a Nidoking lead, Star Raptor lead, probably Scarf, I'm going to have to imagine. What do you think about that, Kyle?
I think that Gubs actually led with the Nidoking's mascot just to get into his head. Turn one.
That is a very, very viable strategy. That you cannot doubt the psychological warfare that goes on in these kind of events.
It's true.
Yeah, and you know what? They're fighting really hard for that Utah Jazz Waffle Maker, and they can't take any chances that that'll put themselves in any kind of disadvantage. So they gotta play hard.
That's true. The winner is going to be getting that Utah Jazz Waffle Maker, along with being the GBA champion. But turn one already taking a long time. They're really thinking about their moves here.
Well, it's the championship. You can't make any false moves.
That's true. Yeah. The falsest of plays could cost you the match here. And you got this far. You won your one big playoff game.
Yeah, the huge playoff wins.
The huge playoff win. And we've been thinking for a long time. I just my second sip of my drink during this one turn alone.
That double thirst.
Yeah, quite. Gub's going to be switching out of his Nidoking here. He's going to... What's he going to go into here? It's going to be Bird that is, without a doubt, his Skarmory. I don't know. All right. Oh, a Brave Bird right off the bat by Danza. Of the Nidokings. I'm not sure that was the best play. I would have U-turned, but I guess that's why I'm the worst team in the league. Gets a crit, though.
Oh, yeah. The crit definitely is nice.
Yeah, based on that damage. So the crit did what? 50? So that means... So you think he's Scar... He's probably Scarf based on the damage that the Star Raptor did.
Yeah, I feel like if he was banded, it would have done more than that.
Now, I'm partial to the Rocky Helmet Skarmory, because he has recovery, but that's just me. Mm-hmm. Going into, that is his Empoleon. Oh. As we get Stealth Rocks up and out, I believe the Nidokings went to Empoleon just prior to Defog, a predicted Stealth Rocks.
It was good play, if that's what it turns out to be.
If that's the case. You gotta wonder now, what... what particular moveset that the... if it's not a defogger, what he could have on Empoleon? It could be... I've seen a lot of different Empoleon variants. Running.
True. I mean, there's always the Sub-Pataya variant.
That's true. Sub-Pataya.
You could also have a special attacking variant with Hydro Pump and Ice Beam or Flash Cannon.
We have a switch out here. Skarmory. He's going to go into Slugworth. That's going to be his Gastrodon predicting a water... knockoff!
Wow!
That's going to hinder the... Slugworth's recover. I mean, he has recover, I would assume.
Yes.
But it's that residual recovery he's definitely going to miss, especially seeing that this battle has the chance to be some kind of a stally type match.
Yes, it's very possible, given the video length.
That we don't know.
That we have no idea how long this
video
is.
To be fair, we're going to come clean. We actually have not seen the video, nor do we know who wins. we just got the file live, like I requested. So we actually don't know who wins at all.
That's true. So we don't know any of the
Defog. Oh. Yeah. See, I know that from experience. To use that against me.
Okay.
Defog is slower than an earthquake. That's gonna do a solid amount of damage, probably. That's at least half. Yeah, about 60%.
Oh wow! Yeah. He does not want to take another one of those for sure.
Oh, especially because he has Defog. He's gonna want to keep that alive.
Oh yes. The potential of all those hazards that Skarmory can set up.
Yeah, it's true. He's gonna definitely want to keep his Defogger alive. You can't really do anything to Gastron anyway. So if you're right now the Deoxys in Gub's situation with Gastron, what are you doing there, Kyle? Right now?
I'm contemplating on what he's going to want to switch out. I'm predicting that he was thinking he was going to switch. I don't know if I would be safe and just go for a Scald, or if I would predict a switch and...
Oh, he did go for the Scald. Wow, mm-hmm. What a play. What a play.
Ooh! Ooh, wow, and the burn as well.
And the burn, so that extra damage is going to come in handy. Got a Snapjack.
Things are really starting to heat up now, guys.
Oh, thanks for that pun.
Yep.
Appreciate it, that's why you're here. Got a Snapjack, that was cool, from Australia. Right on, let's keep going.
Alright.
So right now we have Gubs. We're going to refer to them as Gubs and Danza because it's much shorter and it's easier to say. Because we don't know when the moves are going to be made. So we have Gubs as the Deoxys and Danza as the Nidoking. So remember that. So we have both Gubs and Danza. So we have Danza now with a 40% Empoleon and now a 50% and burned Gengar. So right now the Deoxys in a good situation.
Yes, things are looking up for the Deoxys.
Well, for sure. The things are good now. Okay, now right now, Nick, our third color commentator, if you are the Deoxys with... if you are the Nidokings with a half HP burned Gengar against a... Gastron, what are you doing right now? What's your play? Fantastic.
All right.
My play would obviously be the win play. You hit the button.
Ooh, energy ball from
Gengar. You know, it's
brought that just for that Gastrodon, and that's how Gastrodon goes down. How the tides have turned.
That was unexpected. That was quite the plot twist.
Probably, I would assume he's running Energy Ball on purpose, just for that Gastrodon.
I would assume so.
Wow. So we got Danza with an early 6-5 lead, the Nidokings. But you cannot count out the Deoxys. This is a championship match, after all. And I don't see it being a repeat of the Super Bowl.
Oh, in comes Heatran.
Heatran, Vesuvius, the mountain that destroyed Pompeii.
It's true. He's... actually the reason that we are standing on all this ash.
Not at all correct, but I'll give it to you.
I think you might be off by a few thousand kilometers, but we'll roll with it.
In about like 1800 years.
Yeah.
Oh, with Gengar going for that destiny bond.
Oh
Heatran falls right into his trap, going for that. Oh wow. So in two turns, the Deoxys lose Heatran and Gastrodon.
It looked as if the Deoxys had the upper hand with Gengar being at 50% and burned, but Gengar manages to get two kills out of it.
Wow, that is, dare I say, ridiculous.
It is.
What a turn.
And if
you
look back to the question posed earlier, he did exactly what I would have done, and he would have won with it.
Yeah, the win. So. He did in fact pick the winning play.
He did indeed hit the winning play.
So now we have both competitors yet to pick Pokemon. Now we've only seen three, or we've seen four of the Deoxys Pokemon. We've seen, you know, we have two left to see. But we have seen all of the Nidokings, so you gotta think. Now, if I were the Nidokings, I would probably just go back out into Staraptor, because he's probably Scarfed, he's probably got U-Turn, it's probably the safest of moves to scout with.
I would also say that.
But if I'm the let's look at the Deoxys roster here. Now, in the playoffs, he brought Roserade, Rotom Heat, Dragonite, Nidoking, Conkeldurr, and Skarmory. So you gotta wonder if he might have, you know, some of those same guys. I mean, we've seen some of them, but we don't know if he's got Rotom or Dragonite or anything like that.
It's true.
And we saw in the playoff matchup with the Nidokings winning, we saw him use Jolteon, Scrafty, Gardevoir, Gyarados, Staraptor, and Empoleon. No, here we go. We got a move being made. It is back into Empoleon. And that is going to be... and a Nidoking for the Deoxys.
Well, I have to say that the matchup favor is in the Oxys' favor, right?
Oh, it has to. Right, you get a third of the Earth Power, a third of the Earthquake, and with Gengar gone, that's one less floater. I mean, he's got at least Staraptor. He could have Gyarados to also, you know, weasel his way out of a ground type move.
I'm thinking a nice Thunderbolt would be a very safe play right now.
That would be the safest of plays, because even if he went into Staraptor, dodging the predicted Earth Power, he would hit super effectively, regardless.
Did he bring Jolteon?
Oh.
Even if he did, though, Jolteon is, that's true, as we all know.
I mean, yeah, that's a bet, actually. So he's got a tough move here. Oh, he does go for the Thunderbolt. Oof, so you might not have Jolteon. I probably missed on the first. And, oh, he lives! He lives that one to get those Stealth Rocks up. Oh, my goodness.
I cannot believe he lived that.
He lives that one. He's probably max special defense. He has to be.
Oh, he has to be.
Oh, wow. Lives that one to get those rocks up. And now the Deoxys have to deal with Stealth Rocks on their side of the field. That's going to be, dare I say, a hazard for them.
Yeah.
Dare you say.
One could say it's a hazard.
And it goes for the Earth Power after that, so. Empoleon goes down. We're tied at four, but now one side of Stealth Rock's up. And I do believe losing Gastrodon is going to be huge for the Deoxys going forward, because it could have, you know, could have walled Gyarados if he had Gyarados.
Indeed.
It could wall potential. It could pretty much stop Staraptor in his tracks with Recover and all that, and Scald.
Not to mention, it can spread valuable burn around with that Scald.
Yeah, very valuable burn. But
yeah.
So regrettably, we scored out tied at four. So at least it's still staying close, which is nice.
Indeed.
And we have no idea what move the other player is going to make.
Back in comes Staraptor.
Now, not seeing Intimidate, that means he's obviously got the Reckless.
Indeed.
For those Brave Birds to do more damage. So now, what are you doing if you are the Deoxys with a full HP Nidoking up against a essentially full HP Staraptor? Nick?
I would predict the U-turn and just go for a move that would hit something else that he has on his team.
Such as maybe an Earth Power, perhaps?
Perhaps. Maybe Earth Power might not be the best option. It seems like Thunderbolt might be the best option again. Possibly Ice Beam as well. That's what they're there for, those coverage moves. Brave Bird may fail to KO a Nidoking and the recoil damage.
We kind of concluded that it's scarfed.
Yeah.
So,
but he has not been afraid to use Banded with Quick Attack, so you never know.
It's true. He's been known to do that.
Yeah, so, I mean, it is, but we did, well, based on the damage that we saw from the, on the Scarf, we can safely conclude it is Scarf, but this is a tough spot, because turn one, actually, this exact same matchup, and we had the Staraptor go for a Brave Bird, so, you don't know, that's obviously got to come into play when making a decision here, if you're the Deoxys.
Yeah, especially considering turn one, he opted to switch out of Nidoking in favor of a better matchup.
That's true, and which was Skarmory. So you got to think. So I got to think if I'm the Nidokings, I'm going for a U-turn. He's probably gonna go into Skarmory, and you want to get that switch up on Skarmory. But that's just me. Oh, going for a Brave Bird. What am I now? That's why I finished last in the league.
Wow.
Going for that Brave Bird, and that, how much is this gonna do? That is gonna do. A Sash? What? All the tricks of Focus Sash Nidoking with an Ice Beam. That should take it out. That is a dead Staraptor. Oh my god. We got tricks everywhere. That makes sense now why he led with it.
The plays.
Yeah.
And that just goes to show you that tricks are not only for kids.
It's true. Wait, I was under the impression that Danza had rocks up.
I
was as well. So what happened? Did he spin him away? We didn't see it?
I have no idea.
Well,
interesting.
The three of us in the booth are mystified.
And it isn't until the 2015 season that we will be seeing instant replays, so...
Yeah, we don't quite have that technology available to us.
Not yet.
We gotta get the league to vote on it and stuff. You know how it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The fans were in uproar about it.
The fans... Yeah, oh, yeah, the clamoring. I'm getting clamoring right... Can you hear the clamoring? Can you hear the clamoring? That's the clamoring on my window. The Nidoking switching out going into to take a predicted ice beam, Mike. Oh, Conkler, that fat ass Conkler.
Conkler.
Ooh, a shadow ball.
Ooh.
Predicting
a head power ice, maybe.
I thought. Ooh, this special defense drop is gonna be huge.
That's rough.
Wow, that is rough. That is rough.
Now, Conkler, I've seen in the gym, his preferred workout plan is Dance Off the Fat by Richard Simmons.
Yo, my mom has one of those old, like, sweat into the oldies, like, fucking tapes. Yeah. She's using all the time. I follow him on Twitter.
I bet he is a great follow.
Only on
the outfits
people.
He posts are hilarious.
And those outfits.
Oh, those outfits are fantastic.
I actually think that's a borrowed outfit from Richard Simmons that Conkler is wearing right now. That pink harness suit? I think that's actually Richard Simmons.
I approve of that comment entirely. So we have it's a 3-4 in favor of the Deoxys with a now it's a neutral essentially Conkler because of the special defense drop. I'm assuming he's assault vest. I could be wrong, but I'm gonna be assuming it's assault vest.
I would take a guess and say that Jolteon just goes for another Shadow Ball.
Now we have quite the match here. We have Jolteon being the MVP of the league at 13-2, and Conkler in third place with 11-3. So two heavy hitters for sure on this team, right in this matchup right now.
It's true. It could go either way.
A combined 24-5. These two Pokemon right here for the season.
I would think if Danza were going to switch into a potential Gyarados, it would be now.
And the switch happens right now to a Gyarados. So a great call there by Nicholas.
And the Intimidate.
Oh, the knockoff! Getting rid of that item.
Yeah, probably the leftovers.
That did a lot, even after the Intimidate and stuff.
True.
Yeah, get rid of the leftovers, and now he has a red Gyarados up against a Conkler. I think I'm the only one who likes bulk up Conkler for like times like this. Like, I feel like I know he's not, but if he was a bulk up set, he probably could sweep him. I'm going to have to assume that Gyarados is a bulk, because we've seen the bulk Gyarados from Danza many times this season.
Multiple times.
And I feel like
who is surprised that Jolteon wasn't sporting a hidden power flying for this matchup? I was slightly surprised.
Oh, going to Skarmory.
And also a little bit facetious.
True.
The taunt on the switch into Skarmory. What a prediction.
That is.
So now the Deoxys cannot get their rocks back up.
It's true. Which would have been very helpful against Gyarados switching.
Everything.
And just getting that extra damage in on the Jolteon as it comes back in.
It's true.
The more rocks damage you're going to get on Jolteon, the closer you'll be able to kill with Mach Punch. So.
That's true. That's true. That is very true. That is quite the astute observation there from.
And just wait till I'm actually in the league. Oh, spoilers.
Yeah, I'm not ready for that. He's going to think of stuff I don't even want to go up against. Nick, we're not playing this year. Out of Gyarados. What? Going into his Jolteon named MV Poke.
To resist the Brave Bird.
I would have just started to set up. I don't know.
I'm not a fan of
he's probably that defensive Gyarados is why he didn't start setting
up. You're right. So we have a Skarmory now and a Jolteon at about almost the exact same amount. They're both at about 75%. We got three Pokemon left for the Nidokings and four left for the Deoxys. Deoxys still with the numbers advantage.
Knowing now what we know and what the players do not know,
we don't know anything that the players don't know. We do,
because we're able to objectively view Danza's plays, so what Gubs might not see...
Critical hit on the Togekiss! Oh my god! The Jolteon take out Togekiss with a critical hit!
That is...
Oh my god.
Wow.
I can't imagine what was going on with the Deoxys game plan there.
He was going for a Thunderbolt again, or a Volt Switch, but he probably assumed he could live it because it's fucking Togekiss.
True.
Wow.
True, but it's really do you think that
actually, because that was a crit Volt Switch that killed it, that might be a Specs Jolteon?
It could be.
That's the point I was getting to. I was going to say that it may have been the best option for the Deoxys to let their Skarmory die off right there, because it doesn't, it's not really that important
anymore. Yeah. Skarmory going for the defog. So now I'm even more confused about the Stealth Rock play.
Yeah. What happened?
Are we all just stupid?
There was Stealth Rocks up on the...
And there was a Focus Badge that got activated. It's unless true. He put the rocks
well,
up.
Well, as you
was
all
in.
Know... As
no, he probably put
know,
the rocks
I
up
when
Little
King
was in. We're all just stupid.
So,
we missed it.
Are you sure it wasn't Skarmory that used Stealth Rocks and then Empoleon that used Defog before?
No, then... Well, I know that Empoleon used Defog, but then Empoleon... Oh, I know what happened. The Thunderbolt from Nidoking did fail to kill Empoleon. And then that's when he got rocks up.
You're right.
So that's the sash.
You're right. Yeah. We fixed it, comments. We saw our error, comments.
We did.
Please don't comment that he did that, because we see it now.
Hindsight, it's 2020, which is still a better record than both of the other teams in this call.
So, Kyle, are you getting the same error that I'm getting?
Yeah.
Are you getting the corrupt
data
error?
Yeah, corrupt data.
There's no way I waited 2 weeks for this file for it to be corrupted.
We are 20 minutes into this narration.
I'm uploading this. This is not going to waste.
This is,
I'm legitimately upset about
this. On the record, the winner of the 2014 Season 1 GBA Championship...
No. This is not how it's ending, damn it. I put way too much work into this season. I am legitimately angry that I spent 21 and a half minutes going through a video I did not yet watch.
Kelsey Bone Connecticut Suns jersey for this?
What the hell is this shit? Yo, I'm upset.
I dusted off my Tennessee Titans Javon Curse jersey for this.
Bravo for that one. This is how the finals are gonna happen. The match happened. Fuck. What do we do? I'm not wasting this recording.
It's not.
What do we do?
Okay. I know what we can do.
What can we do?
We can party. I don't know. I got nothing.
Well, there's a black screen now.
Yep, it's a black screen now. Everything's just gone to shit.
Oh, you know what happened? Mid-battle, Smogon banned everything.
Oh, yes.
It's like the Super Bowl when the lights went out, except we can't retrieve the battle.
A blackout during the GBA finals.
All right, you know what we're going to do? So you still don't know who wins. I don't know who wins either. I don't know. I want to know. I want to know who wins.
Fine. Now on next time on
Dragon I know. Ball you know what Z. I'm doing? I'm getting the battle code from either one of them. If it doesn't exist, oh my god.
We should be part one. We should just start narrating from the point where we left off.
Yeah, we will. That will happen. So this is part one. I'm upset. You all should be upset. Boo.
Boo corrupted data.
Fuck. How does this happen?
Could the mysteries of Pompeii?
It's Chernobyl, man.
It's Chernobyl.
Is that Chernobyl?
This is the worst twist of all. I'm sorry for everyone that watched this. I'm sorry, but in my defense, I was also hoping to see who the winner was, because I explicitly said I don't want to know until this moment in time.
Oh man.
Well, stay tuned, I guess, for the finals. This couldn't have had... I could not have had a worse finals to this season.
Stay tuned for the dramatic conclusion of the GBA.
The GBA Season 1 Championship. Goodbye, everybody. Internet, good morning. My name is Magnitude, and welcome to part two of the GBA finals. Our last recording got corrupted, so here we are, part two. Let's get you up to speed in case you missed it. The finals is the Los Angeles Nidokings at 7-4. That counts their playoff win. They have 3 Pokemon remaining. And then we have the Arizona D-Oxys, like I said, 8-3. That also counts as playoff win with 4 Pokemon remaining. Nidokings coming out of the, I believe, Kanto Conference, and the D-Oxys coming out of the Johto Conference. This is the end of Season 1, this video, and then I will have a video up about Season 2 tomorrow, what's going on with that. I'm going to be a lot more GBA intensive as my channel rolls on. Starting with season 2, there's going to be a lot more GBA stuff coming out for my channel, more than once a week at least. So, without further ado, let's just kind of recap a little bit based on where we left off last time. We had the Jolteon of the... now we're on the opposite side. We have the Jolteon of the Nidokings, and he's going to get a crit volt switch to take out the Togekiss. That's going to tie the score at 3 apiece. Like I said, we are now on the side of the Nidokings here. He's going to then... He obviously gets a switch out of a Jolteon. He is going to come in with his Gyarados, and as the Deoxys has to do, got to go into his Skarmory to... take out, you know, what he can, and wall this thing as best he can. We have the Sea Snake, the Gyarados of the Nidokings, and go for a taunt that's going to neutralize Skarmory, so we can't use Defog, get rid of those Stealth Rocks, which is going to be a huge hindrance. And the recording froze actually at this exact spot last time. As with Gyarados came out, the recording froze, so I still don't know who wins. Let's see what's going to happen. All right, that's going to be Nidokings. I'm going to Jolteon again. And to predict the Brave Bird, I assume going to resist that Brave Bird coming from Skarmory, which does, as you know, look really dope. And he's going to take that so, so well. It's going to prevent Skarmory from using Roost as well, because, you know, he's been taunted, so he can't do that. Now, I'm going to try and commentate like it's live, because like I still don't know who wins. I don't. I did my best to shield away. I got recorded way too much at the end, so I'm going to end up cutting that off there. Just so I didn't know who won. So, gonna go into Conkeldurr, probably Assault Vest on another Volt Switch, which I believe this is what, yeah. Yeah, the Deoxys had to make that move. It's gonna take a Voltage well. And I was gonna see Gyarados coming in, but Gardevoir works as well, and gonna trace the guts. I don't think it's gonna get Status, which I guess is unfortunate, but either way. Oh, a double switch by the Arizona Deoxys. Is this a prediction? Predicting Skarmory to come back in. I guess he predicted Gyarados, but he's still going to take some of that hazard damage, and that's what's going to be happening there. But he's going to go for... Oh, the Nidoking's going for a Moonblast. Will that be enough? Oh, not quite enough to take out the incoming Skarmory. But I do believe he's going to outspeed, so he's probably going to be able to take out Skarmory anyway. Yep, switching up moves, so does that mean Assault Vest, perhaps? Maybe Leftovers, hasn't taken damage, so we're not quite sure. That's going to make it 3-2. So the Deoxys down to 2 Pokemon, the Nidokings with 3 going back into Conkeldurr. And he's going to put in some serious work against this Gardevoir. Oh, he's going to go right for the Moonblast. Is this enough to take it out? It is! 3-0 on a crit! 3-1, the Nidokings are one Pokemon away from becoming the champions. And all that, oh, that is the way Nidoking goes down to Stealth Rock. So that is how the season's going to end. The Los Angeles Nidokings are going to win 3-0 and be the GBA Season 1 champions. Wow. Congratulations to the Nidokings. The links of both players will be in the descriptions below. Season 2 starting up real soon. We got a lot of new stuff coming for Season 2, so be sure to check out my, you know, video for that tomorrow. Hope you all have a great day, and later days.